Hello students, so welcome to the session. Today I'll be discussing the topic which is Visual C++. So Visual C++ is a programming language. So it is a programming language. So as you know, the programming language that we are going to have that is used for developing some kind of applications. So application is any software which will be used for a specific purpose. Consider you have notepad or your video player or audio player, those kind of softwares will consider it as applications. So Visual C++ is a programming language that is used to develop applications. So that will be working in the, or the Visual C++ will be using the concept of OOPS, which is nothing but object oriented programming language. Now we have already discussed the one type of object oriented programming language, which is C++. Similarly, we'll have VC++, which is also object oriented programming language. Now you have started using one particular software or IDE called as Visual Studio. So Visual Studio is an IDE. What is this IDE? This IDE is used for developing applications. So as I told you, this application is nothing but software. So if you want to develop any kind of software, we have one kind of IDE which is nothing but Visual Studio. This IDE, or when you want to develop this application, we'll be using different kind of languages. Suppose if it is an application that is using a language called as BASIC, or it is a application which will be developed with the help of C++ programming, or if I'm using a language called as web-based development, which is like HTML or JavaScript, if I'm using those type of coding languages, that will be one more separate type of language that we are using. Okay, now what in general I am trying to express is Visual Studio is an IDE or a package that is used for developing an application. So this application can be developed while using different kind of languages. So under that, one of the type of language that we are going to study is Visual C++. As the name says, Visual C++, because we will be using the IDE which is Visual Studio. Under Visual Studio, we are going to see how we are going to write a C++ program to create an application. So all these applications, or whatever application that you are going to create using Visual C++, will be used only on Windows. Only for Windows based development. If you consider, you have different types of operating systems like Visual, like if you consider Windows, you have a Mac, or if you have a one more type of operating system like Linux or Unix, those type of operating systems it will also have separate applications. But if you consider Visual Studio, by using which I can develop applications for Windows. Now coming for Visual Studio, as I told you, Visual Studio is what kind of programming language? It is object oriented programming language. Since it is object oriented programming language, we will have the concept of object. Now, what is object? Object is any runtime entity. So we will consider it as a runtime entity, or we will also consider it as instance of a class. So object is a runtime entity, or it is also called as instance of class. What does this mean? What does this mean is, like, as you see, object is nothing but, whenever I say runtime, runtime is when you start executing the program, you are going to allocate some memory for the objects that is present in the class. Okay, suppose if I create a simple class, if I create a class with a variable, I'll name the class as example. Suppose I have two variables like integer x, and I'm going to create one more variable, say integer y. Consider both are public variables. Okay, so I have two variables here. I want to create the object of this example class. So if you want to create object of this example class, we are going to use something like example e equal to new of example. this is what we have already discussed in your previous semesters, like in C++ concept, how to create an object. Now, so what is the object is? During the execution of the program, it is going to create an object. That object name is E. Okay. So as you see, you have a keyword called as new here. New is nothing but it is used for allocating memory. When you want to allocate memory, I will be using the keyword called as new. By using new keyword, once I allocate memory, that memory will have the variables like x as well as y. Okay, these variables can be used whatever function that you have in the class. Suppose I have a function called as add. So this function add can use these two values x and y and can perform some calculation there. Okay. So similar kind of concept we'll consider it as object. So object is a runtime entity where it will be created during the execution of the program, which contains the objects of the class. Okay, whatever element that you have defined or members that you have defined in the class, that will be, or that particular variables will be present in object. So by using this object, we can access the members of that particular class. So this is about what is object. Now we are coming to the next topic. We will be discussing what is class. So class, you already know, class is collection of objects or collection of similar objects. We will consider it as class. Now that is the basics about your object oriented programming language. Okay. Now next we will